right, doing some shopping. Don't have my meals packed with me. We're going to go to this place, Tropical Smoothie Cafe, and try to get something somewhat clean and healthy. I don't want to opt for a smoothie because I don't want the sugars in it. So I think they have some chicken wraps or chicken salads. We're going to try to go for that right before we go train right now. Let's check it out.
Check the Thai dressing. See if it's even tastes fattening. It's actually not. I think it's just ginger and soy, so it shouldn't be a lot of fat. So I'll put it on my salad.
Thai
chicken salad. That's all breast. And you got a what? Totally green smoothie.
Tastes good.
All right, guys. We're back at Walmart, Wally's World after the California Pro. And I'm addicted to these sweet potatoes because I'm a big proponent of saving time, and you can microwave these bad boys all at once for 10 minutes, and it's super time saving and convenient. And then they also have, so those are the sweet potatoes, and they have it, of course, in red potatoes and gold potatoes, which are not nearly as nutritious as sweet potatoes, but I'm gonna get these anyway, just to switch things up. This is at Walmart, and I tell you what, it beats the hell out of skinning these and then boiling them for like 40 minutes, pain in the butt. So now does it leak plastic and xenoestrogens and chemicals and stuff into the potato? I wish I had a 100% answer, but I don't for that, but it probably isn't the healthiest. But right now I'm down for just time saving, so this is what we're gonna do. This Walmart, I tell you, look at this clever little pre-cut, crinkle-cut sweet potato fries. No added oil, so they're fat-free. It's literally just sweet potatoes, ready to rock, ready to dip in reduced sugar, ketchup. That's pretty amazing. I'm gonna get some of these too. They won't be microwave, I don't believe. I think they're, you're gonna put them in the pan fryer or roast them, however you wanna do that. So that's pretty amazing. I'm happy about that. I usually get my sweet tea, some diet tea over here. And it looks like, Meatless came out with his own sweet tea. Looks like it's unsweetened, no calorie. Meatless Sarchev, man. All right, I know I said I wasn't gonna do anything cute with my diet, but
you are.
I just couldn't. I couldn't resist, guys. You guys know I'm a bagel monster.
And every time I buy yogurts,
Rachel
eats all of them.
Does not need to be filmed right now. And but the good news is, guys, this is only 1 gram of fat, carbs post workout. I'm not gonna do this every day, but you know what? I just want to try this. If it is limited edition, as you can see, limited edition. I don't want to miss out on something so glorious as carrot cake bagels, so I am going to do that. But you see all the yams I got. Sweet potatoes galore. Tilapia. Look at me. I'm being a hypocrite and using tilapia just because it actually does taste good, the texture, with mixed with sweet potato and ketchup. Sweet potato, ketchup, and tilapia all mushed together.
What are you doing?
Nothing more adorable than a cat reaching his paw out to grab something.
Do you want some? Yeah? Here. Right here.
Hot day in Vegas here, and need to expedite the process of thawing my fish, so why not take advantage of the environment, right? Here we go. Look at this. Got my flounder thawed out. Not overly thawed, guys. It's just a little bit thawed out, enough to grill. Got my tilapia. And of course, orange roughy, ready to leak out my butthole. Because that's what orange roughy does. And that's how we expedite the process. Now we're gonna choose the Weber to grill these bad boys on. All right, guys, so this is the way I do it. I take my Reynolds foil and I just put about 3 sheets over the grill, spray it with some non-stick cooking spray, and then just lay out my fish. Once I'm done, obviously it doesn't stick really because the cooking spray, and then it doesn't mess with your grill because it's layered with foil, so it's nice cleanup. So I'm layering on my tilapia, and I got flounder here, and I'm gonna go put on my orange roughy too. So a variety of white fishes, of course the flounder and the ruffia's wild caught. Tilapia's farm raised and feeds off feces, I'm pretty sure. So the feces pumps are pretty amazing because it's pro-inflammatory, so you get some inflammation from it. And that's how we're cooking the fish. And nothing fancy here. And then we're gonna do the 10-minute potatoes in a bag, which is, God, I love those things. The convenience is just amazing. And that's what we're gonna do. All right, guys, the fish is off the grill. And the wonderful, convenient potatoes in a bag. This side up. And they are done to perfection. Nice and soft, it's perfectly cooked. Pretty much better than what I could time in the oven. And they're ready to rock, man. That's easy as can be. 10 minutes for the sweet potatoes. And then the regular red, white, and gold are a little less, so it'll be 8 minutes for these guys in the microwave. And then they get them, like I said, just absolutely perfect. Perfect texture. Perfect doneness, and they're all good. There you have it. And here's what the meal looks like. Little a concoction of multiple white fishes, flounder, orange ruffy, and tilapia in there. Sweet potato, and of course the red potato. And to make this the best meal on earth, reduced sugar ketchup. This is absolutely mandatory for this meal. It ties everything in together perfectly, and you can essentially just mash everything up, the fish into the potato, into a big mash of deliciousness. And this is pretty much imperative, guys, for any potato type food. And there it is. That's a common meal I'm eating now about 3 to 4 times a day, and then whey isolate with cream of wheat or oatmeal. Very basic, still fat slob, still a lot of squishiness to dig through, a lot of butter to churn, but we will get there with stuff like this.
All right, so we just finished up barbell squats for 5 or 6 sets. Now we're going over Smith machine squats. We've already done 4 to 5 sets of building up ascending weight each time, and we're gonna finish it off with a double drop set, 3 plates, 2 plates, 1 plate, and I'm not doing leg press right now because, once again, leg press irritated my kneecap, so we're just going to stick with squatting movements for legs. Hope my back will keep up. So far, it feels decent, and I don't have a belt, so that's a plus. Here we go. Guys, post leg training, and we're at Denny's over IHOP's, because IHOP's is actually a lot more expensive, and Denny's is on par in my opinion with similar items, and you can also get healthy things here too. So I'm gonna keep things healthy, of course, because honestly I feel like I haven't gotten much leaner at all. I might have even gotten fatter. So even though my levels are 800 or whatever, I guess I'm over expecting things and maybe expecting too much. Maybe I'm delusional, but still not anywhere where I want to be, even though I'm up about 20 pounds. We're going to do a bod pod tomorrow to see where I'm at after 5 or 6 weeks of 200 milligrams. And then I will start a replacement dose of growth hormone after that and see what my body composition is after 6 weeks of adding 2 IUs a day of that. So that'll be very interesting. So I'm documenting everything with compound by compound with a body composition test for the bod pod. So
build your own omelet, egg whites, chicken breast. Don't worry guys, I'm not gonna eat the hash browns. There's too much butter on there, so I got some dry toast coming. So egg white omelet with added chicken and spinach. Rachel kept it good and healthy with the avocado salad, some chicken breasts. And she still has her juice over there. She's milking. So not too bad of a deal from Denny's here.
All right guys, what's up? It's Thursday afternoon here, and I'm here at CVS Pharmacy, local pharmacy here. They have a minute clinic, a walk-in clinic. And what I'm doing actually right now is I'm gonna get a basic work physical, just something on record. There is a company right now that I'm talking to, a clinic that does bioidentical hormone replacement therapy, all that stuff, that I might start collaborating with if I like them and I feel comfortable with them. And then I can reveal what the company is and kind of recommend it to clients and people that are viewing this and give you my feedback just for additional medications that I might want to implement into my plan, my HRT plan, whatnot. So basically they just needed the blood work that I already had, which is pretty extensive, which is obviously your CBC, metabolic panel, all that stuff. But they also want on file, which I respect, which is good. They want more information. They want a basic physical too. So everything's legit and checks out okay, just on their end. So we're gonna go in and get this basic physical. Hopefully nothing too crazy happens here, and we'll see what happens. Results are in for the bod pod testing after about 5 weeks of TRT. And I'm just gonna go over the numbers from 5 weeks ago prior to starting TRT and now. So it's only 5 weeks, guys, and I had a feeling my body fat would go up, but that's okay with me because muscle's coming back on. So the old bod pod reading 5 weeks ago was, my body weight was 218 pounds. Body fat was 12.5%. Lean mass was only 193 or 191. Now, 5 weeks later, my body weight, empty stomach, no clothes, is 240 pounds. So that's about a 22 pound increase in body weight. Body fat is at 15% even. My lean mass went from 191 to 204, so about 13 pounds of muscle gain in 5 weeks. That's pretty much, I kind of expected these results. 15% body fat, I don't think I've been that high for, I don't know how long, but now that you know we have what happens after TRT of just 5 weeks, now we're gonna add in a therapeutic dose of growth at 2 IUs a day, and then we're gonna retest again 6 weeks later and see what happens again. And I think this is good information for you guys. It's kind of interesting, and keep following along. All right, just got the bod pod done. Now we're going to a favorite little spot here in Summerlin. Echo and Rick Steakhouse for some happy hour. Not gonna fill up on anything. It's gonna put more fat into those fat cells of mine. So they have a really nice shrimp cocktail, which is refreshing on a hot day like this.
$2 steak and egg.
$2 steak and eggs, I'm gonna stay away from that. I'm just gonna munch on some shrimp cocktail and enjoy the pretty scenery out here. Maybe we'll eat outside, who knows. So this place is a restaurant upstairs, then a butcher downstairs, so pretty awesome top quality meats here. So you can actually just take some stuff home and grill it up too. But stuff's fresh. You can pick out your own steak and see it before it's cooked. And they usually have beef jerky, homemade beef jerky too, but I don't see any right now. So we'll ask to see if we can get some jerky too. This place is pretty awesome.
All right, guys, here we are at Echo and Rig. Just got our appetizers. This is why we come here. Wonderful quality food, and these are only $1.99 each for these shrimp cocktails. You get a really good supply. And we got the ahi poke right there, the poke bowl. And of course, our endless diet Pepsis. And now you see why we come here. So it's worth the 30-minute drive to relax. And then, of course, we can go shop and kind of walk around and get some cardio in, too.
All right. Final set, which is going to be a drop set. Simple movement, barbell or easy bar, stand-up curls for biceps. I'm going to be straight up with you guys. I built my arms in the beginning off of very, very heavy barbell curls. I used to be able to do like 185, 205 and curl it for 6 reps. I'm going to be honest and just say as I got more progressed and I started implementing like insulin and growth hormone and all that stuff, I did soften up on my arm workouts just to save my joints. I started going light. Just getting a pump because they were growing just from the products. So now I'm getting back to the basics and I'm very weak right now. I'm gonna try to build up my strength even for arms. So we're gonna do this. This is heavy for me right now, and we're gonna do a drop set. Start the old fashioned way, not rely on the product so much.
Desolate, no cars. It's like 11 p.m. It's just our car and probably a worker's here. Beauty of 24 Hour Fitness in Las Vegas is that it's just not really popping and cracking and people don't really want to go here apparently. It just means that we have the gym to ourselves to do whatever the hell we want. So it's whatever, deadlifts, barbell rows. Here we are trying to get focused here at this gym. All right, I see one person over here. Cable cross, no, yeah, cable tricep extension. Other than that, nada. No cardio bunnies,